this is almost the perfect daily driver. So here's the reason why I think this is the one of the perfect daily drivers is because a lot of people still want to have a full-size car, body on frame, they want the space, they want rear-wheel drive and a V8. You can't buy that anymore. Crown Vic is pretty much the last one that was body on frame, and that's it now. So a two-wheel drive truck is essentially a big body car. This has independent front suspension, nice long wheelbase, it's lowered. So one, we have less maintenance. It's gonna handle pretty good because of the suspension and the stance, but we have room for five people inside and we have a really big trunk. So what we have here is a very interesting Chevy. It's a 2007 and a half. So this is the very first generation or year of the new body style, the GMT 900. And you'll notice what's interesting about the truck is it's gonna look different to you because it has a few conversions. One, we have a Tahoe front end, and then we have Trailblazer SS wheels, but they are aftermarket. The bolt pattern is actually for a full-size half-ton truck. Everything bolts on. We'll also notice this is a Chevy truck, but the bed is off a GMC. That's why the fenders look the way they are. So we have Chevy front fenders off a Tahoe, but we have a Sierra rear box. So we have these nice fenders. Keep in mind the taillights don't interchange between the two. Also, the other cool thing over here is we have a tailgate grafted into the rear of the truck off a C10. So this looks a lot like the newer trucks, but it's on the older style because the older trucks just had small badging on them, and I think this is a really nice touch. This truck is really set up like a car. So you can see it's full carpet inside. So good and bad. If you want to treat it like a car, this is awesome. If you want to use it more like a truck, you might not want to use the carpet, you might want to do a bedliner style instead. What I do like about this is this will catch all the dirt. You could hose this out if you wanted to, and you can see that the owner is using a mat to help protect it as well. So the interior, again, it's been converted, so it is the SUV. We have Escalade front seats. Now, what's cool is it's a modified vehicle, but it's using all factory parts. So everything fits really nice, everything works properly. The gaps, everything lines up. You're not dealing with weird aftermarket pieces that might not match up to each other. And I like this style a lot. Where I live, this is not a very common conversion. Usually what people do is they'll do Denali or Escalade, but to have the front end of an SUV on the full-size half-ton, it just looks proportionally perfect to me. When it comes to this body style, I like the Sierras more because they have the signals in the middle. I like the layout of the grille. Because if you want to do switchback LEDs that go from white to amber, the GMC Sierra works a lot better. But I think the Tahoe front end looks way better than the Silverado front end. Just the way it's proportioned and the way they place everything. Now checking out the interior, there are some cool little touches. You can see the controller for the air ride. It is perfectly flushed into the overhead, which is a great place to put it. Aftermarket head unit. There actually is a full sound system in here. So you see the custom sub box down here underneath the seat, making good use of the space. Some people like to use it for storage, but if you're trying to run a sound system in a pickup truck, that is one of the few places you can put it if you're trying to get good amount of bass or SPL out of it. There are options to put them in the center console. From factory, they do make them, but you're limited down to like a 6-inch or an 8-inch, so which is good for some bottom end, but if you're actually trying to make bass in your vehicle, you have to go with something like this. So you see the custom enclosure is only on one side of it. We can have access to our jack and everything, and you still have some room for storage underneath. I do like seeing all the touches that it's themed properly. So you can see from the door skins to the dash, it's all the same trimming. So when I sit in the vehicle, I don't really think anything of it. Like when I first saw this truck, I knew it looked different and looked really cool, but I didn't understand it. And then I looked at like, oh, the front end's Tahoe, the rear is a Sierra, the wheels are a replica Trailblazer SS, but they're, instead of doing 20s, they're 22s. The only real giveaway is because it is a Chevy, it still is the GMC steering wheel in here. That's probably my only gripe about the whole thing, but it has all the nice trims and changing out the emblem isn't hard. So an observation I made is, to me, this is a cool look because it kind of looks like a dually in some ways. So, and what I mean by that is the fenders off of the Sierra box have this nice line, but they have this big bulge to it. And these replica wheels for a Trailblazer SS, the offset's actually pretty much perfect, that they tuck in just enough that they don't create a lot of stone chips, but they're not so pushed in. And it also is a 22-inch wheel. If it was a 20, look okay, but then you'd have to run a fatter tire. So to have that low profile look, you have to step up to a 22. Now looking at the fender of the Tahoe, very different look to it. If you look at side by side, but then you get that nice bulky look. You don't have this so squared off look. You get a differentiation from the front to the rear, which is a nice touch without actually doing any custom work. Under the hood's pretty basic. It's got the 4.8 liter. It's got a throttle body spacer, and it has the Duramax alternator, which helps with the sound system and everything. And the second battery tray we see here is a compressor for the airbag system for the rear. It's just a leveling system, so when the owner's towing, it just levels out the truck. Here we can see the airbag system just to help level it out. But the truck is very clean underneath. A little bit of scaling rust, not much at all. Especially given the year, it's a 2007 truck, because it doesn't see winter driving. So in the winter months, he was driving another truck. That's why this one is in pristine condition. I believe it's the original exhaust system in here too. For those of you that have a keen eye, you'll see their rear disc brakes. For those of you who know, on a GMT 900, there aren't a lot of options for rear disc brakes from factory. The SUVs had it, your heavy duty trucks will have it, but if you have a half ton pickup, the only one that we know of is if it has a Vortec Max in it, the 6 liter, then it'll have this. Like, I was shopping for a Denali recently, I was just looking at it, I think it was a 2013, and it still showed drums in the picture. So we assume for half tons, you only get it with a 6 liter. So why are there disc brakes in this? Is it a conversion? Yes and no. The rear axle is actually off of a 2014 truck. So it's a little more updated, it's a little more beefy, but we have factory hardware for the disc brake So now if we're doing any kind of maintenance, it's much easier. So what you have to do is, for your parking brake, you will have to change out the cables to the truck that has the 6 liter, the Vortec Max option. That way your parking brake and everything works properly. And I believe the owner had to change out the U-joint back here for the drive shaft and everything to work. But for the most part, all factory parts, all bolts in, don't have to do any weird fabrication back here. The motor's original, but the transmission has been updated. So it's a new transmission here, and it has all the updates. So as far as I know, it has the Beast Sunshell gear in it, or an updated Sunshell that's a weak point, updated clutch packs. I'm also assuming that the accumulator piston's been changed out, and also the servo. They might put a Corvette servo in, which is very common to do. Basically, all the basic updates have been done on this transmission. So on these trucks, compared to the GMT 800, the sway bar on, like, my truck, my 05, is over here. They've relocated in the back. Makes a lot more room here because they've moved out of the way. I assume on a four-wheel drive truck, it just makes it easier to have the drivetrain there and then moving everything out of the way on it. The shocks on this are actually fairly large, which is cool to see. But again, typical GM, small steering parts. So here's something interesting about this truck. Some of the parts of this truck were taken off of a police Suburban. Suburban Tahoe have the same front end. What the owner noticed was, compared to their stock fans, these fans blew really hard, and he was trying to understand why. So doing some research, found out that the police version of the fans is actually different than the civilian version. They blow a lot harder, which makes sense because police vehicles do a ton of idling, and the stock fan might not be up to the job if you were to idle the truck for hours on end, because that's the nature of the job. So that's the cool thing you do, is it works with the factory computer and everything, but you can upgrade to police grade fans, and then you can put a Duramax alternator in and not spend a ton of money and get updated charging and cooling capacity. Also, if you ever can, if it's available to you, get police grade brakes. These aren't it, but if you can get a police rated caliper and rotors, it will be more durable. Now, here's a quick tip for you guys. If you are doing a SUV to pickup conversion, if you're doing the hood, which you have to get this bracket off of another truck in the junkyard, or you're gonna have to fabricate your own. The sprung hinges will not hold up the SUV hood. That's why if you look under the hood of an SUV, they have this strut. It's to pick up the extra weight. We're assuming because they're just a little bit thicker, there's more sheet metal, there's more design going on. These hoods that ended up being heavier, GM, I guess, made an afterthought. And instead of redoing an SUV spec hinge, maybe it got too heavy or it's too hard to close, they went with this strut design over here. Well, there you guys have it. This is a near perfect daily driver to me. It's two-wheel drive, very simple. It's low to the ground. It's a big size, lots of space. It's got the smaller V8 because we don't need a ton of power. So fuel consumption is on the lower side for a vehicle this size, and it's simple. No variable valve timing or anything. Lots of space to work on it. So you can do a lot of the work yourself. And the cool thing is it's a custom truck, but you don't need any special tools. The only fabrication that was really done on this truck was the bracket to the firewall and having to figure out the parking brake cables. Everything else just bolts right on.